couple of people here who want to speak, but they have a schedule, so they're trying to keep the schedule. So we're starting this a few minutes earlier than we normally do. I'm Bruce Hightower. I'm the president of AGLA, which is Arlington Alexandria Gay and Lesbian Alliance. And I just want to thank a few people. First, I'd like to take and thank Freddie and Johnny for hosting this event at their home. This is the third year. And Freddie will be out momentarily. He's got another event to get to. The other person I would like to pay a big thank you out to is Roland Watkins, who is here in the center by the AGLA table. He provided all the ice cream for AGLA Social today. Thank you, Roland. Thank you very much. AGLA is a 501c3 grassroots organization that is works very hard and is not limited to its advocacy, education, as well as its celebrations like we have here today. And I would like to thank a few people. First of all, I would like to thank the board of directors and all of the volunteers that come out to make these events successful, as well as a few politicians and delegates who come to these effortlessly and we've been given their job duties and their descriptions that they have to keep on top of these events. So with further ado, I'm actually going to introduce John Feistat to come up to the stage and say a few words. He has to really get to another appointment, and I would like him to say a few words.
Thanks a lot, Bruce. So I'm John Feistat, your independent member on the county board. As many of you know, I ran as an independent in 2014. I put together a rainbow coalition in every single sense of that word, across the political spectrum, the ideological spectrum, the geographic spectrum of Arlington. We won not once, but twice, because voters wanted a choice. They wanted a little balance on the county board. Fast forward, we established an independent auditor. We're turning away from gold-plated, expensive projects. I'm emphasizing managing our growth, greater openness and transparency in county government, and cost and value. I also want to say to this group, I am the county board liaison to Arlington's Human Rights Commission. That is a very important liaison responsibility for me. I work with Carlos, the chair, Roland Watkins, the vice chair. Every year, as you probably know, the Human Rights Campaign puts out an index as to how municipalities around the country are doing in terms of policies for the LGBTQ community. Arlington is one of the best. We're rated in the low 90s. That falls short of 100. I can assure you that it's my... Yeah.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Oh. Thank you. suppose many of you support that decision, but you're probably unaware that Washington Lee High School is different than the other high schools in Virginia that are being considered for this action. And that is that Washington Lee High School is a civil rights icon. It was one of the first high schools in the state of Virginia to be integrated. So it should not be renamed, it should be remembered. Now, with respect to my opponent's actions on this matter, you probably are not aware that the school board, in a midnight decision, unannounced and unagendized, voted to change the name of the school. This was contrary to a policy that the school of the superintendent himself, Patrick Murphy, had put together for the school board's use in considering this matter. In other words, they disregarded the advice and recommendations of their own longtime superintendent. So, if transparency matters to you, and I, in talking to voters all across the county, transparency comes up as the single major issue that's of importance to them. If transparency matters to you, you will definitely vote Clement, the independent, for school board this year. Thank you.
Thank you, Audrey. So the last person that I have, and they're going to give me a nod if they want to change their mind in speaking, is they do not want to speak. So I'm going to introduce to you the Democratic nominee for Alexandria City Council.
Yes.
Amy Jackson.
Yes.
And she's got her arm up here. And with that, everybody has had the opportunity to speak. Is there anybody that I missed out here? Put your hand up. And no? Good. I always miss somebody somewhere during my speeches like this, so I have to keep a list. With that, I'm going to just finalize with one thing. AGLA has an organizational event that is coming up. It is a candidates forum for Arlington County Board. It is going to be held on October 24th from 6:30 to 8:30 at the National Rural Electric Building, and it's against the two candidates that you heard spoke today. So please come out and support it. There'll be an opportunity for AGLA to offer some questions about the LGBT community up front, and then it'll open up to the public attendance to ask questions from that point on. I want to thank everybody for coming, and I want to thank the AGLA members who go to so tirelessly and supporting and offering their resources for events like this, as well as the education and advocacy that we prove throughout the year. So thank you, and everybody enjoy the ice cream.